Hi friends, how are you? I hope you're having a very nice weekend. So these are some of the messages which came in today, and they were little messages, one after the other, and I would like to relay them to you. Now these messages were coming from the universal source, so I will just begin with the messages right away to make it worth the while. So friends, what I was being told was that I need to tell you certain things, and I will just begin with them. So, you know, sometimes the twin flame and the soulmate or the divine connections or relationships are made to be very rosy and very easy peasy. Now, I would like to tell you that these twin flame or soulmate relationships are the truth is further from, you know, this easy peasy. The truth is that these relationships are very challenging because they encourage growth. These relationships go through lot of ups and downs because they are relationships meant for your growth. Now, whatever is wanting to be healed in you, let's say you have 8 different issues that have been there from your childhood days up till now. Let's say you are 35 years old, or even 55 or 65, whatever is your age, which does not matter, it is irrelevant while I'm talking about this. So let's say you had 8 different issues. Now all those 8 different issues are going to be mirrored back by your twin in a way that, you know, when you will want something of the same nature as the issue, your twin will reject it, you know, and you will feel unbelievable overwhelmed, because you will feel that this person who is my divine partner should at least understand this. But the truth is that your divine partner signed a contract that he or she will be the most highest person who will actually show you the mirror, you know. So like you are trying to feel and see that, you know, whatever my lack and whatever my weaknesses were, he will be the person who will put a cover on that wound, you know, and he will be the person who will understand that wound. But what universe does is, the universe makes them reflect that wound in such a bad way in you that you have to get over that wound by yourself, being alone, and cover up that wound in order to be with them. Now, why the universe does it is because that is your most prized possession, you know, that is the person you want to have, you know, in your life. So in order to get there, the universe puts these blocks of your unhealed wounds in front of you, that if you want to catch that person who you feel is your divine partner or is your highest good, then you have to go through that. Now going through that at that point seems very hard and very challenging. That is why these relationships are very challenging and not easy peasy waiting for the time to come, you know. So when you go through them at that time, go through the obstacles at that time, they feel like hell, you know, you feel like you're going through hell. First you feel that you went through all those wounds in your childhood, teenage, and now you're going through them once more, you know. But that going through them once more is the way when it now feels very hard, but at the end of it you will realize why your twin flame was given to you. Just to heal those wounds, because you could not heal them through other soulmates or other ex-lovers who came to you, you know. Because those ex-lovers were not the highest version of reflecting them back to you. They did reflect them back to you also, 50%, 40% or 60%, but they could not do it 90 to 99%, which your twin is doing now, you know. That is why there are times in which you have emotions where you hate your twin, literally, you know. And then you again thaw, your feelings again thaw, and you again come to loving him. But you will feel that there's a lot of back and forth in your own emotions also. That is because he's reflecting all your things back to you. He's triggering you. That is called triggering. He's triggering you. Let's say you take my example, let me just give you a general example. Let's say if I had some issues where I thought that I had this belief regarding men that they are no good and they just leave you when you have the maximum a situation where you need them maximally, you know, they kind of abandon you. So I might have had past life issues with abandonment, or I might have had past life or this lifetime, you know, something might have happened in my childhood years which I do not remember, you know. It could have happened before you were 5 years old or 6 years old that you don't even remember, or it could have happened in your teenage years. But for me personally, nothing happened. But if we take this example, now what will happen is, if in my adult life right now I will have some issue where I would need somebody, that person who is my highest partner or person who is closely connected to me or intimately connected to me or my twin flame, he will abandon me at that moment, you know. While we are in going through the journey before union, you know, he will abandon me at that moment, and I will feel that this person was the one who should have stood by and he is not there. So that is when my abandonment will cry out so loud, you know, it will cry out so loud, and I will feel the pangs, and I will sit in my room and I will be highly depressed, and for 5 days I won't meet anyone. What that is showing me is the abandonment template is still in my DNA. I have not let go of that abandonment which happened to me in some past life 100 years back or 200 years back or 1000 years back. I have not let that go yet, you know. So my twin, because he signed the highest contract with me in heavens or in by the universe, or you know, energetic contract, and don't take it literally that a contract was signed or something like that, but you know, it is your best people in life, or your best friends, or your best of everything who can actually help you in this way, that they actually sign a contract that yes, we will do everything to make this person grow, you know. And you signed a similar contract for your twin flame, you know. When maybe now is the time that he wants to hear from you, and he's you know, really going gaga over hearing from you, and he wants your messages and stuff, but now you are coming into an empowerment energy and you're way ahead of him in healing, you know, yourself. So you now know that you are not going to send this person a message, because he has to grow up to be able to interact with you again in a healthy way, because you just don't want sexual booty calls, you just don't want this relationship pattern to go on as it has been going on. So you are taking your stand now, you know. You are reflecting back to him his wounds or his shortcomings, you know, or his wounds from a past lifetime, which means that, you know, when he's not up to the level of stepping up to an honest and dedicated relationship, the other person goes away, you know. So you are also reflecting things to him, you know. When you, if you look back in hindsight, you have reflected back to him also, you know. You do not know when he is in separation, you think that he's just after karmic partners or just in addictions or just in those things. But he is also yearning for you in the same way that you are yearning for him, you know. So it is a two-way street, you know. The only thing is, the masculine does so many things in 3D, or the masculine energy, or the masculine divine does so many negative things in 3D, that the focus is always on those. Either he's a player, or he's in 3D partnerships, you know, with karmic partners. So a lot of content is available for the divine feminine, either on social media or otherwise, to actually blame the masculine twin. Like, not even blame, the whole focus remains on what 3D things he's showing you. And because the female is always chasing after those 3D things on social media, she forgets somewhere that her own life is also there. And he is also stalking you in some way. He is also looking at what you are doing, you know. So when you are posting things on your social media which are motivational messages or messages of depression and sadness and what is going on, you know, he is also seeing all that. He is also seeing that you are in energies where you are feeling this way, in depression or overwhelm, and he is in the similar energies. But his way to deal with depression and overwhelm is just go into the arms of another person, because that is how the universe has planned this journey, that once he gets overwhelmed and depressed, you know, he runs into the arms of another person, and that another person again kicks him back by showing him the lessons that he needs to learn. So it is a kick after another, you know. Don't think that the karmic partnerships are easy. I've described in one of my previous videos also, which has a image of foxes, you know, a very dark image on the thumbnail, where I've shown that how the divine masculine is dealing with lower energies for this journey, you know. So don't think that their part is easier. The thing is, this whole thing is not easy peasy, you know. You have to be a warrior, you have to be strong, and you have to first of all recognize your wounds and you know where the blocks are, or you can contact a spiritual master for that. You are welcome to come to me. The inner work list is just $20. Inner work list is, it actually tells you all of your blocks, you know, but for that also you have to send me the story, and that generally is done after you get a general reading, after you get a personal reading. But it can also, follow a personal reading, like a twin reading or a twin plus confirmation reading. If you have been given the twin journey, take it positively, because God is giving you a chance to mend your wounds, you know, which you didn't even know existed. Once you clear those wounds, you're going to reach a state where you're going to feel so good about life in general, whether you are with your twin or not at that point. You're going to feel so good and healed in your energies. And I will also tell you how that actually feels. You know, that actually feels like, you know, if you've had a sexual encounter with your twin, you know, not just anybody, with your twin. And then you're after completion, you're lying with him on the bed, you know, and not just right after completion, maybe half an hour after completion, and you feel that your muscle tension is totally gone, and your legs are totally relaxed, you know, and you have no muscle tension at all. That is loss of resistance, you know, because you've had an encounter with the person you deeply love. It is not a superficial affair. It is a very deep love. So that deepness, like, kind of cleanses you like water is cleansing your body, you know, like you are just in a pool where you're floating, you know. That kind of a non-resistance, happens in your life in general without having that sexual orgasm, you know. It just happens in general that you start feeling that light and that loose, you know, in your energy, that your cells, your cellular level is so healed that you do not need anybody's love at that point. And that is the paradox, that when you don't need anybody's love, or when you don't need that codependency, that is when the divine love returns to you. Because when you start feeling that way, so light and so consolidated in your energies, he also feels the same way. Because if you have healed, like I always say, the feminine can heal the masculine through her own inner work, you know. So if, let's say, you are coming to me for some inner work and I'm healing you, but also indirectly, in the same amount, I'm healing him also indirectly, you know. And sometimes I will specifically give you inner work for just him, that you have to do, you know. So it works both ways. So he will also feel that lightness and consolidation in energy, and he will also come to the point after many karmic partners, or one karmic partner, or two karmic partners, or no karmic partner at all. He will also come to the point where he will feel that he doesn't need anybody. He is consolidated in himself, and he doesn't need any other person to fill his void, because now he has filled his void himself. At that point, when both of you will feel this feeling that I'm describing, that is the time of union. And till you are not at that point, you should just assume by yourself that you are not close to union, if that is your aim. If your aim is spiritual ascension and spiritual growth, then so be it. But if your aim is union, you need to be feeling this way. And sometimes you will feel this way at multiple times, and you will think union is coming. But that is just a preparation. When you will start building upon these energies, energy slowly and slowly, you should know by yourself you're close to union. And you know, on this twin journey, I would also suggest it is good to go to a person who knows about twin flames and who is adept at that particular matter, and you will be very safe, and you will know how to work with your own energies as well. So this was my little thing which universe wanted me to speak on, to show you all of the persons who are new and all of the persons who are already there for many years, you know, that this is how this journey is, and this is how it goes forward, you know. So you have to be very vigilant, you have to be very strong with it, and you have to be very alert also, you know, in doing everything. And the outcomes will come, the goodness will come, the positivity will definitely come. So with that, my friends, I hope you're having a very nice weekend, and you will be very excited to hear more from me. Thank you very much for any personal services. The information is always down below, like you always know, in the description boxes, and you can self-pay any day, you know, make your choices, see what services you need, and just go and do the needful, and you will be served. So, God bless you. Have a very nice weekend. Many kisses. Love you all.